What's popping, y'all? It's Friday. Tell them to cut that check, bitch. So y'all, listen, I just gotta tell y'all about this little scenario that happened, right? So I was talking to a female that I know. Really, I know her through Facebook, through watching my videos and stuff like that. But me and her was talking one day, and she was telling me, you know, about a situation that she got herself into with a dude, right? So she was basically explaining to me that she was dating this dude for like a year straight, right? And so she was explaining to me like all these terms and conditions the dude had her up under, right? So she met a dude, you know, they connect, they kicking it or whatever. So they start off just talking on the phone or whatever. But it was always at only certain times of the day and certain days of the week. So to me, that's a red flag for me. But to her, it didn't seem to be a problem, right? So of course, they end up liking each other more. They start going on dates and stuff. But she was telling me like it was stipulations on the dates. Like, so it got to the point where she realized basically she couldn't really talk to this man till after 7 o'clock every day. And when they did go out, like on the weekends or when they went on dates and stuff, they always went like to another city out of town somewhere. Like it always had to be away from the city that they live in. So I'm telling her, like, you know, that's a problem for me, but you know, it don't seem to be an issue to her. So it got to the point where it almost became a routine, her dealings with this man or whatever. And of course, he had an excuse for every time she say she questioned, like, why we can't get together during the daytime or whatever it may be. So I'm asking her, I'm like, so y'all, you know, y'all took any pictures together, or you know, you've been with him for a year, you know, let me see what he looked like. So she's showing me pictures of him, but all the pictures, this man got like on a hat pulled down low and he got on shades. So you really can't see how he looked. So I'm like, you know, I ain't never seen you post him on your social media sites or anything. And she was like, no, he don't want no pictures of him posted. So I'm like, okay. So all this stuff is like a red flag to me. Like something ain't right. But she swear he just, you know, such a good guy. He treat her real good. Like he take her out, he buy stuff, like all of this stuff. But, and I'm like, so have you ever been to his house? She was like, no, you know, he always come to my house. Like, that ain't no problem. It don't really matter to me. So I'm like, you don't even know where he live at? She was like, well, I know where he live. I just never been there. He always come to my house or we go out of town or whatever. So to me, I feel like you being treated a certain type of way. But to her, she say because like the sex so good and the vibe so good, like everything just was fine to her. So really when she went to explain to me, it seemed like the only thing that really got her attention is like the sex. When she went to explaining like, oh, his sex is so good and he do this and he do that, and oh my God, it'd be like this and we go out of town and we'll lay up for weekends or whatever. So she just was explaining to me how she was just into this dude so much for a whole year straight, right? So it got to the point where as she explained more and more, I'm realizing like, this man had you as like the low-key side bitch. But she, when she telling the story, she don't understand. So after she get done telling me everything, she only can call him after 7. She have to text before she call. When anytime they hang out or go out on dates or do anything, they go outside the city. Like they go out of town instead of just going right around. Even if it's, she's like, even when they go like out to eat dinner and stuff, the restaurant they want to go to could be here, but they'll go to the one in Tampa or the one in Orlando, like away from where they live at. Every time they taking pictures and stuff, the dude got on a hat and shades. Holidays, she ain't never went around his family. He'll come to her house. So fucking Thanksgiving, Christmas, his birthday, all that stuff like that, they celebrate, but it ain't on that particular day. It'd be later on when he can get around to her. So I'm like, well, if he ain't got no kids and stuff, like, why are you so separated from his life? So she don't see nothing wrong with it. To me, the bitch been segregated for a whole year straight, like from like what the norm is. So when she get done explaining her story, I'm like, so listen, back like before like 1954, before like the, you know, the state case or the federal case, Brown versus the Board of Education, you know, black people were segregated from white people, right? As far as like us not being able to eat at the same restaurants, us not be able to come in the same doors. If we were allowed in the same particular building or whatever, we had to take the back door. I'm sure you know about Rosa Parks, how she, you know, sat on the front of the bus, but they used to make black people sit on the back of the bus. Like we had to be separated. So when I get done explaining that, she's like, well, what that got to do with my situation? So I'm telling her, well, from my perspective, your ass was in a segregation situation. Like, you was the bitch that had to, like, go to the restaurants out of town. You can't go to none of the ones in town. You can't call to after 7. Like, all these damn stipulations just remind me of when black people were segregated. Of course, it's on a more milder level, but bitch, you was with a dude that kept you segregated for a whole year. So now she explained to me, the whole point of her telling me about her situation was, after like a year of dating this dude, She ended up going out one day to a restaurant in the city, and she ended up seeing this dude with a lady. The lady turned out to be the man's wife. The man told her he don't have any children, but he got a kid with the lady, and they live together and everything. So now she's so hurt, she cries, she upset, like the dude done misled her. So I'm telling her, yes, he dead wrong, but at the same time, you have to take personal accountability for your role in the situation. Like, what the hell? You don't understand that all this time the signs was there for you to see? You got all these stipulations. You don't let a man fucking segregate you for a whole year. And then when it come out that your ass like fucking been segregated, you looking crazy like you didn't see, you didn't have no signs of what was going on. So imagine me being back in segregation times and the people don't let me come through the front door. I got to sit on the back of the bus. Any place I go, I got to sit in a separate section that say colored. All this shit going on. And then one day when I have a confrontation with a white person and it come out that they don't like black people and that's why I had to come through the back door, I'm acting surprised. Bitch, how the fuck is you surprised? Wake the fuck up. You can't call him till after 7. You can't never go to his house. Y'all don't spend holidays together. Y'all got to go out to eat and hang out of town. Only thing he do is basically sex the fuck out of you. Like, you ain't a part of none of his everyday, daily life in front of nobody. You was a motherfucking secret. Bitch, you was segregated from everything. Your ass was made and conditioned to feel like it was okay to be separated. Just like the fuck when black people were separated. Motherfucking sitting around in a restaurant in the back part like you ain't worthy enough to sit in the front and eat with everybody else. You know what? Dr. King would really be disappointed if he knew about this. So me and her kind of laughed, but you know, her feelings was hurt or whatever. But I'm just telling her, as a woman, you got to goddamn see the signs. And she like, well, I don't know what to do. Bitch, you do know what to do. Leave that man alone. Now, you can be like these bitches, like what I posted about yesterday. To where you can go and you cannot be on this mission to take this man from this female that he with, this woman, this lady that's clearly there prior to you, clearly because they fucking live together. Yes, you was lied to. Yes, he tried you. Yes, you was disrespected. But why even give the situation any more attention? Fucking suck that shit up. Put your motherfucking feelings in your bra or your goddamn purse and move on. It's levels to this motherfucking shit. And you determine what level you want. Now, you can stay on that low-ass level and keep being a side bitch and try to take this man from this female. Or you can tell him, nigga, fuck you. I figured out what the fuck you doing and move the fuck on. And that year you wasted, chuck that shit up. It's Friday, man. Y'all get a check. Levels to this shit, man.